church disciples of Christ, welcome here to this portion of Christ's body in this world. How good it is to be here in this place. This is my favorite front pew. This is wonderful. It is good that you are here, and it is good that you brought your family with you, that we can share good news in this space as we celebrate the anticipation of the Incarnation, as we ready ourselves for this Advent season and for what season might come next. May our hearts be joyous. May our minds be present. May we celebrate with one another. Of course, we invite you to stick around, not only for our service here, but we invite you to head downstairs to our fellowship hall for a potluck. Disciples, whenever we gather, we break bread together, and we have a wonderful opportunity to do so. So we invite you to stick around after worship, to head downstairs, to break bread with us, that we might get to know you a little bit better, and that we might more readily find the Christ in our midst. There's a lot going on this month, everywhere, right? It is a busy, busy, frantic season. We keep busy as well, though we try to do so mindfully, though we try to do so with presence. That is the case. You can see some of the announcements in our bulletin this morning. Primarily, we invite you to Bible study on Tuesdays as we're going through the Gospels. We invite you to our Christmas Eve service, which is, well, it's Christmas Eve at 7 p.m. We also invite you to our Christmas Day service at 10 a.m. with a traditional service, the lessons and carols. We have quite a bit going on, and you can take a look at what we have going on in our bulletin. We do want to bring your attention to one special day offering that we have. This is, of course, we encourage you to be a part of the financial stewardship of our congregation of the Niles First Christian Church. The offering plates are right by the doors going into the narthex there. But we do have a special offering that is in the bulletin this morning. It will be taken today and next week. This is our Christmas special offering. This particular offering goes directly to the region of Ohio to support mission and ministry. And it is basically the offering that sets the budget for the region every year. So if you feel led, if you've worked with the region and seen the good work that they do in mission and ministry, or if you would like to hear more about what they do, I'm more than happy to share that with you. With these things being said, is there anything that we have to offer this morning as announcements?
Good morning. Nice to see all of you here. First of all, I want to say thank you for those who participated with the Angel Tree for Cadence Care. They will be here. Looks like all the donations have come in, and they will be here this Wednesday morning to pick up all the goodies for the kids. Also, in your bulletin, which I'm sure you are awaiting, there's this little insert, double-sided. Do you all know what that means? Audience participation with our Sunday school program. So I hope you enjoy.
This is our best opportunity to sing those Christmas carols during the Advent season. So everybody that's asked for them, please sing up, raise your voices. I see you, Shirley. I see you. You and me. We'll sing them together. How good it is then. How good. Let us begin our service this morning with the lighting of our Advent wreath. I invite you to hear this, one of the O antiphonies. O Orient splendor, Lucius Aeternae, et sol justitiae, veni et illumina sedentes in tenebris et umbra mortis. O rising one, splendor of eternal light and sun of justice, come and illuminate those sitting in darkness and the shadow of death. Here we light the candle of peace. We discern in its flame pathways of just peacemaking, different from the militarized and coercive peacekeeping of empires. We are reminded in its flame the God-given command to live peaceably with all people so far as it depends on us. We see in its flame glimpses and glimmers of the kingdom of God, where lion will lay down with lamb and swords will be beaten into plowshares. As we allow this flame to burn brightly in this sanctuary and within our hearts, may our prayer be that peace prevail, and let it begin with us. May we join together in singing of One Candle Is Lit.
Mm-hmm.
invite you to join me in our call to worship. Good morning, dear children, parents, and all who gather in the warmth of this Advent season. Today, our hearts are filled with joy and anticipation as we embark on a special journey through the story of Christmas. As we light the candles on our Advent wreath, let us be reminded of this hope, peace, joy, and love that Christ brings into our lives. Each flickering flame tells the story of God's promises fulfilled. In this season of waiting and wonder, let our hearts be like the stable in Bethlehem, open to the arrival of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. As we sing and celebrate, let us remember the true meaning of Christmas. So let us join together, young and old, in this Advent adventure. With open hearts, let us worship our Savior, the light of the world, who brings hope to every heart and joy to every soul. Amen. I invite us then to join together in a time of sharing. We use part of our worship together to lift up each other, to celebrate our joys with one another, to struggle with that which burdens us. Do you have something to share? No, just waiting. I see you. So I invite us as a congregation to name our concerns, our joys, so that we might celebrate and mourn and work with one another. Jim. Peace on earth. Oh, keep that prayer going, Jim. Let it begin with me. Yes, I'm sorry, I don't think we've met before. Can you tell me? Hayden for safe travels, certainly. Thank you, Kelly. I had to do it. You know I had to do it. Carol. Carol asked us to pray for Mara with health issues. Jeanette asked us to pray for the family of Lori Harper. Thank you, in her passing. Monica. Help me out with that spelling, I'm sorry. That wouldn't have been my guess. So for the Prochaska family in the passing, of Jimmy. Thank you. Oh, okay. Thank you, Gordy. Lifts up Al Cooper with health concerns. Oh, I give thanks for this morning, y'all. I give thanks for each and every single one of you being here today and sharing this message with us. I invite us then to move into a time of prayer. First a silent, individual prayer, bringing these and all that weighs on our hearts to our God, who certainly hears us, but in the naming that we might be those who move with our Lord, who seek to comfort, to heal, and to celebrate. I then invite you to hear the morning prayer and to join together in the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Great God, Emmanuel, you who are with us, as we gather here today in the warmth of your presence and love, you who abide with us, we are filled with joy and gratitude for the precious gift of your Son, whom we anticipate in this season of preparation and readiness. We come before you with hearts full of anticipation, especially as we celebrate this Christmas season with children in our midst. Lord, we thank you for laughter that fills rooms, for the innocence and wonder reflected in the eyes of these who share this story with us. In their joy, may we catch a glimpse of the pure and unbridled delight that the first Christmas brought to the world. We lift up these children before you, Lord, knowing that they are a reflection of your love. May they find joy in the simplicity of the story of life, the story of a baby born in a manger, bringing hope, peace, joy, and love to all. We lift up parents and guardians that they may guide these children with love and patience, helping them to grow in wisdom and in grace. May they be reminded of the importance of family, of love, of kindness during this season and during all seasons. Lord, bless these teachers and leaders in our midst who invest their time and energy in nurturing these young hearts. Grant them wisdom and creativity as they share that story of life in ways that captivate the imagination of all. As we anticipate the celebration of the birth of Jesus, may the meaning of Christmas shine brightly in our hearts. Help us, Lord, to embrace the spirit of giving, of kindness, of compassion, of peacemaking, of justice-seeking. May the love that was born in Bethlehem be reflected in our actions and our attitudes, especially here as we interact in love and in kindness with these family members, these friends, these children, these strangers. We entrust this time in our gathering to you, Lord. May it be a time of joy, of reflection, of inspiration for all who are present, especially those who hear the story for the first time, or for those of us that hear it anew again. In all these things, might it lead us to one voice, one mind, one heart, that we might be in accord with all that the Christ has lived and taught us, has died and resurrected for. Indeed, may our words be the words of the one whom we celebrate in this season. May we pray in one voice that prayer that God's Son has given us when we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who have sinned against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Well, I invite us to turn to our Bibles this morning. If you brought yours with you, or if you want to turn to the Pew Bible, or if you just want to follow along with us on the screen here, this from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. May God add a blessing upon this and every reading of God's holy word. May we then hear this story told afresh by these voices sharing in our midst. Mm-hmm.
slave wherever he goes.
Jesus' story can be told in so many different ways. It can be shared with joy from our youth. It can be repeated each Advent season. As we gather around this table, it can be shared over bread and cup. The narrative can tell stories differently, but the good news remains the same. That in the person of Jesus of Nazareth, whom we know as the Son of God, the Incarnate One, the Messiah, the Anointed One of God, in this one we find life, life abundant and eternal. When we gather, when we sing, when we break bread, when we share stories, our center, our focus, our illumination, our guiding star is the one that we know as the Christ. Here at this table, we tell the story again, that over bread and over cup, we have covenant with our Lord, where we find life, where we find one who has sacrificed for us, that we might give of ourselves for each other, that in doing so we might bring forth the kingdom of God that this one whom we celebrate has taught us of. So may I share this story as it has been shared with me. But on the night that Jesus last ate with friends, with family, with those that would deny him and those that would betray him, he took a loaf of bread, and after having blessed it, he broke it, saying, "This is my body broken for you. Whenever you eat it, eat in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took a cup, and after having blessed it, said, "This is the cup of the new covenant shed in my blood. Whenever you drink it, drink in remembrance of me." For as often as we gather, as often as we sing, as often as we share stories, we proclaim the one that has come for us, that we might be for each other. And we proclaim this until Christ comes for us again. So I invite you with what you have gathered to take bread and to partake as Christ's body broken for you. And in like fashion to take cup and to partake as Christ's blood shed for you.
Lord, this Advent season, may we focus on the one you sent to save us and how we can least best love and serve one another each and every day. May our collective actions prepare the way and make straight paths for the day Jesus returns to this earth. Amen.
thanks for abundance. We give you thanks for the abundance that you have bestowed on us individually, that we might share abundance with one another. As our cup is overflowing, let it pour forth in grace. Let it pour forth in love. Let it pour forth in peace and in joy. In all these things, might we be strengthened and sustained, not only by the meal, but by your abiding presence, O God. May all those that have had a hand in this potluck set before us, from those that have grown the food, those that have transported it, those that have cooked it, those that have brought it, in that long line of humanity that allows this feast, might we find you, O God, and might all those that have had some hand in it find blessing in you as well. In all these things, we give thanks and praise to you, O God. Amen. Hear then, hear our benediction. As we go forth from this place, may the joy of Christ fill your days with laughter, and may the love of God guide your every step. Go in peace, go in love, and go with the anticipation that every day is a step closer to the celebration of the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ.